nature's most beautiful, complex, and captivating elements. Yet, when it comes to recreating it digitally, water remains one of the most elusive challenges for artists and game developers. From the quiet trickle of a stream to the explosive crash of tides, simulating water is no easy feat. But have you ever stopped to wonder how 3D artists, game developers, or filmmakers make water look so real? How do they create a world where water feels alive, interacting with the environment, reacting to light, and moving in a way that seems natural? Today, we're going to break down how water is replicated and simulated in games and films. And trust me, the techniques behind it are nothing short of genius. Water is a dynamic element. Its behavior is influenced by a multitude of factors: gravity, surface tension, interaction with other materials, and light all play a role in how water looks and behaves. In nature, these things work together seamlessly. But in the digital world, replicating this interaction is incredibly difficult. Whether it's the slow ripples of a calm lake or the violent waves of a storm, water's motion has to feel organic. And yet, it must also be efficient to render in real time or as part of an animated sequence. There are two key places where this challenge is tackled: films and games. Both need water to look and behave like the real thing, but they use completely different methods to achieve that goal. Avatar: The Way of Water is an example that pushes the limits of what we think is possible when it comes to realistic water simulations. The goal was hyper-realism, but what did it take to achieve that level of realism? Well, the folks at Weta Digital, the studio behind the film, developed an entire system for simulating water. A system known as a particle-based fluid simulation, where each individual particle of water behaves like a tiny entity. This system allowed the team to simulate everything from underwater bubbles to massive waves crashing against the shore, factoring in the effects of tides, wind, and the seafloor on aquatic environments. They didn't just want to simulate water, they wanted to simulate life itself. So to do that, they developed a specialized framework called Loki to mimic everything. Every droplet, every wave, every splash was calculated to interact with light, the environment, and even the characters. Some scenes even featured water interacting with over 50 creatures in a single shot. This Loki water state machine was crucial for delivering the sheer volume of large-scale water shots in the film. In a typical VFX-heavy movie, water shots of this complexity are rare and often require many iterations from highly skilled artists. But what makes this process so mind-blowing isn't just the precision, it's the time. According to reports, Avatar: The Way of Water required water effects for 2,225 shots, some taking up to 8 days of simulation to achieve the high resolution needed. Some complex water scenes even took weeks to render on powerful computer systems, with one specific scene taking 2 weeks just to simulate the water movement alone, before even factoring in rendering time. Imagine waiting that long just to see a single frame of water simulated. This level of detail is what makes the water in Avatar, The Way of Water, feel so alive and realistic. But what about games? They don't have the luxury of weeks of rendering time. They have to simulate water in real time, on your screen, often with complex interactions happening as you play. So, how do they do it? In games, water simulation is just as important, but the approach is radically different. For example, Sea of Thieves, one of the most famous examples of stunning water effects in games. The developers at Rare used Unreal Engine's Niagara VFX system to create water that looks dynamic, real, and interactive. Using Gerstner waves, the team was able to simulate ocean waves in a way that feels natural. These waves are mathematically modeled, and the beauty of the Gerstner wave system is that it allows for efficient real-time performance while still creating complex, detailed water effects. Waves crash dynamically, respond to the player's ship, and even interact with environmental elements like rocks, islands, and weather conditions. They optimized their water physics by moving 128 Gerstner wave computations to the vertex shader, allowing for detailed normal maps while maintaining smooth performance, up to 90 frames per second on mid-tier hardware. Now, you might be wondering, what exactly is a Gerstner wave computation? In simple terms, it's a mathematical model that mimics the natural motion of waves, allowing developers to make them feel alive without overwhelming your computer. That's pretty brilliant, isn't it? This means players can sail through storms and feel every wave, without any lag, and this is what makes their approach so brilliant. Another game that showcases impressive water simulation is The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. Water dynamics are tied directly to the player's actions. The waves in the ocean respond to Link's movement, making it feel like the environment itself is alive and reacting to the player. Advanced shaders and handcrafted textures make the water feel believable, even if it's a stylized version. Now, take a moment and think about Assassin's Creed Odyssey or Red Dead Redemption 2. The water in these games looks lifelike, but instead of simulating it in the same way films do, the developers used vertex shaders to create real-time reflections and wave behavior. The water in Red Dead Redemption 2 feels incredibly lifelike, thanks to a combination of real-time fluid simulations, reflections, and dynamic interactions between the water and the environment. Rivers, lakes, and even puddles react to your movements. Step into the water, and it ripples and splashes in a highly realistic way. But what makes these techniques work across all these games and films? Shaders, caustics, particle systems, fluid simulation, and lighting. These are critical in both films and games. Shaders control how light interacts with the surface. For water, shaders determine reflection, refraction, transparency, and even absorption. A water shader simulates how light bends and reflects off water, creating the shimmering effect you see on oceans, rivers, or even puddles. And when light passes through water, it bends and causes light patterns on the surface beneath. This is known as caustics, and it's a key element in making water look realistic. Both in films like Avatar or games like Sea of Thieves, Uncharted 4, the use of caustics adds a layer of depth to water that helps it interact with light naturally. Particle systems are used to simulate splashes, foam, and bubbles. Particle systems are responsible for simulating small elements like water droplets, mist, and foam. When you fire a gun into a lake or jump into a pool, the particles make the interaction feel real. And lastly, fluid simulation. This is one of the most complex computational processes that use algorithms to replicate and simulate the behavior of fluids like liquids and gases. It's the backbone of things like fire, smoke, explosions, waves, waterfalls, and rivers. Fluid simulation models how water flows, interacts with surfaces, and how it behaves when pushed, pulled, or disturbed. In films, it's done in tools like RealWave, Maya, Houdini, or even Blender's fluid simulation, which is considered good for creating visually appealing fluid effects in animations and VFX, but is not designed for highly accurate scientific simulations. This makes it best for artistic results rather than precise fluid dynamics analysis used in industry standard CGI and VFX films. While in games, real-time fluid simulations use optimized models to allow water to behave dynamically. So, what about you? How can you create realistic water in your own projects? Maybe you are trying to create cinematic water scenes in Blender and just want to replicate the techniques we've covered today. Even though there are multiple ways to do this, you just have to find and learn the right technique that works for you. As we dive deeper into this topic, it becomes clear that both films and games use a variety of techniques to create convincing water effects, like normal mapping, which gives surfaces depth, while shaders handle reflections and transparency. Particle systems create splashes and foam, making every interaction feel authentic. But water isn't just an element, and the real genius isn't the tools either. It's how artists or filmmakers use it to tell a story. And when done right, it connects us to the story in ways we don't always realize, making us feel part of the narrative. Speaking of tools and storytelling, let me pause for a moment to share something that's been invaluable to creating content like this: our voiceover. If you've been wondering how we achieve such natural and engaging narration for our videos, the answer is ElevenLabs. ElevenLabs is a cutting-edge text-to-speech AI platform that transforms written scripts into incredibly realistic voices, perfect for creators, developers, and storytellers.
Once upon a time in the narrow streets of London.
Just sharing so much. Aamantrit kar rahe hain. Main bahut aabhari hoon.
Are, ye kitne achhe aadmi hain. Call it in now, hit him with the best shot. Bring it in now, burn him with the high high. Make it moolah. Bada bing, bada boo, yeah. Get loose, get ready for this, it's all brand new, yeah. Catch a vibe to the future. Let me introduce
ya. Aye, lad, there's magic in these old bones yet.
Watch out, big world. I'm small, but I'm mighty.
It's coming up right now. It's coming up right now. And it's looking like, how? Future looks like, oh. And it starts right now.
Let us bring humankind together as one.
With ElevenLabs, you can bring your scripts to life with high-quality narration, whether you're making tutorials, storytelling videos, or even game prototypes. The link is in the description below, and it's an affiliate link, so if you decide to try or purchase a subscription, not only will you be unlocking an amazing tool, but you'll also be supporting us in creating more content like this. Now, let's jump back into the world of water simulation. So, whether you're a developer, artist, or just a fan of great water effects, understanding how water is replicated and simulated in games or films gives you the knowledge to push your own projects forward. It's not just about creating something that looks cool, it's about making something that feels alive. Now that we've explored how both films and games tackle the challenge of animating water, let's jump right into something practical. If you don't want just to know how water is simulated, but want to learn how you can implement some of these techniques in your own workflow, we found some incredible tutorials on how you can start creating your own simulation in Blender, and you can find their full tutorials linked in the description. First up is How to Easily Create Realistic Underwater Scenes in Blender, a tutorial by Regalist. This tutorial dives into essential tricks for simulating realistic underwater visuals inspired by Avatar: The Way of Water. It covers everything from understanding underwater environments using Blender's ocean modifier to emulating light and transparency for photorealistic effects. Next is Discovering Fake Caustics in Blender by Polyfjord. This guide focuses on crafting stunning caustics using Voronoi textures and clever material setups. It provides step-by-step instructions for manipulating textures to achieve beautiful lighting effects underwater. And finally, we have Creating Realistic 3D Water in Blender, The Ultimate Guide by Stush. This comprehensive tutorial explores various techniques for rendering water, including creating materials, animating surfaces, simulating underwater dynamics, and adding foam and bubble effects. By following these tutorials from these talented creators, you'll gain valuable insights into bringing your water simulations to life in Blender. I know there are a lot more great channels out there we even didn't mention, like Max Hay, CG Geek, Blender Made Easy, the list goes on. These channels can teach a lot about water simulation and are still very important and amazing channels to learn water simulation in Blender or even other 3D software. So if you know any amazing channels we didn't mention or tips that are helping you learn water simulations more effectively, share them in the comments. They probably will be helpful for someone looking into learning these water simulation techniques. Creating water in 3D is undoubtedly challenging, but when done correctly, the results can be both visually stunning and emotionally impactful. It still amazes me how much storytelling potential lies in a simple element like water. The animated film Flow, which was made entirely in Blender and Eevee, proves just that. Anyways, if you've made it this far into the video, whoa, you're awesome. It really means a lot to us. So yeah, that's it. I hope you learned something. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.